The water is glistening. There is social distancing, but there's no more missing the bay.
To be able to work in this kind of environment versus being secluded into a house is, it's just uplifting. It changes your whole mentality, your whole spirit.
The governor's stay-at-home order banned recreational boating for 37 full days. That's history in Maryland.
Bay Bulletin was out on day one. At 7 a.m. on May 7th, Governor Larry Hogan allowed recreational boaters to start their season. There's excitement.
Our original splash date was April 10th. We were really looking forward to starting the season then, and I think we've missed a lot of good days of being on the boat or out in the water. We are very, very thrilled to be back.
The new DNR regulations say boaters must be with immediate family or people who live with them. There's no rafting up or docking at restaurants or bars.
There was a collective sigh across the state of Maryland. The boating industry in Maryland is right around a $3 billion a year business. Employs over 70,000 people.
John Stefanchek is the publisher of Chesapeake Bay Magazine, and he serves on the board of directors for the Marine Trades Association of Maryland. He was out with a film crew hours after the ban was lifted, shooting a safety film with our sister company, the Annapolis School of Seamanship.
Yeah, it goes back to basic seamanship. You know, you just make sure your boat's ready, make sure you have life jackets on board. Think about the fact that the water is cold. Even with the life jacket on, cold water can kill. You just want to make sure everything's in good working order.
And Captain John Martino, founder and president of the Annapolis School of Seamanship, says make sure you have a working VHF radio instead of just relying on a cell phone.
And if you take a look around, there's just not many boats out, and you want to make sure that you have a way of calling if you break down or if something goes wrong. Calling for help.
Boating season got a late start this year, so let's do all we can to continue smooth sailing.
But lifting the ban is great because, you know, it's no different than walking around in a park or, you know, going for a jog or being with, you know, your family in another environment. Now we get to do it out here on Back Creek and the Severn and the Bay.
For Chesapeake Bay Media's Bay Bulletin,
feels normal again.
I'm Cheryl Costello.